Let us pray. Gracious Father, as we come before you this night, we are humbled by a wondrous life that you enable us to understand, to live, and to rejoice in. We have gathered this night because you have given to us the greatest promise we could ever hope for, a Son who came to set us free from our sins, from death, and to grant to us eternal life. And so we ask that you would bless this time, enrich and strengthen us, and truly prepare us to touch the lives of many others. As we pray this and look to you in Jesus' name, amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. O come, O come, Immanuel.
Ransom your people, Israel.
O come, our wisdom from on high.
Enlighten our minds with truths we can't deny.
O come, our Lord, with your great might.
Destroy all evil, death, and sin, and grant us life.
O come, you branch of Jesse's tree.
Bring life to us in grace so free.
O come, you dayspring from on high.
Remove the darkness and bring us light.
Would you please join me in the confession of our sins? Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, have mercy upon us. Forgive us and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Upon this, your confession, I, by virtue of my office, to call and ordain servant of the word, announce the grace of God unto all of you. And in his stead, and by his command, I do forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may be seated.
Thank you. Sunday for this evening is going to be sung. Choir will sing first, and then we as a congregation will follow. Let us please.
Everlasting Father, Prince
shall be called Counselor. He shall be called Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Everlasting Father,
Thank you.
Gospel is found in the second chapter of St. Luke, beginning with verse 1. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there is no room for them in the inn. You may be seated.
Thank you.
being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge with baptism for the remission of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. You may be seated.
Kingdom will never have an end. And Mary said to the angel,
"How can this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel answered and said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. And for that reason, the holy offspring shall be called the Son of God. And behold, even your relative Elizabeth also conceived a son in her old age. And she who was called barren is now in her sixth month. For nothing will be impossible with God." And Mary said, "Behold, the bondslave of the Lord, be it done to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. Here is the text. It's nice to be able to speak back at normal speed. This is important to me, probably more for this year than a lot of years, because I was just supposed to celebrate in heaven. Which, by the way, would have been awesome. It's what we do together, by the way. God says we have this right and this privilege to celebrate the wonder of his birth with those who are in heaven. And so there is this remarkable celebration in heaven, as well as here, because we are all tied together by one very important gift. A Savior. We speak of Mary and Joseph, but I have spent a lot of time looking at Mary, in the text of Mary, and this was a remarkable human being that God chose. She was asked to endure, to go through, to accept, and to address issues that are way beyond any human being. But by the grace of God, through the gift of the Spirit, Mary was able to grasp exactly what God needed her to grasp in order to walk a path that he had placed before her. It was not an easy path. First, she was visited by an angel, the angel Gabriel. He was an archangel. The holiness and the presence of God, which is why it is always extended, when a holy angel comes into your presence, is an extension of God's holiness, is overwhelming. It is why she did not know how to take it to begin with. And then he explained, "You are going to have a child. It is going to be a holy child. It is going to be the Son of God." She hadn't caught up yet. "Wait a second," she says. "I'm a virgin. I can't have a baby." And he goes, no, you misunderstand. This child is going to be a product of the Holy Spirit. It is going to be the miracle of God. And so that you will understand how true this is, your cousin Elizabeth, which she knew was barren, way past the age of being able to have a child, he says she is now 6 months pregnant because there is nothing that is impossible with God. Mary is starting to grasp because she says, "I'm a bondservant. I will do what you ask according to your word." Mary was simply a remarkable young lady of faith, a young kid, who trusted in the promise of God, who had to deal with realities. Because God never said, "If you follow this path, it's going to work out well." She tells Joseph, Joseph is planning to leave her. She is now facing life alone, being pregnant in her community, which, by the way, is an overwhelming reality, especially at the time of Jesus. But God interferes. He gives her an ally, a most remarkable gift. He gives her another individual on this earth that has a grasp of what she is going through. It was her cousin Elizabeth. A miraculous baby inside of Elizabeth, and she had this amazing reaction when Mary walked into her home and John the Baptist leaped in her womb. She knew, Elizabeth knew, this was the mother of the God. And it was just remarkable for her because Mary had this older, wiser, stronger woman who was going to explain how to deal with life being chosen by God to do something so remarkable for this world. So Mary had to deal with her parents, her relatives, the community. How many of you are going to believe it if someone that you know came and says, I know I'm pregnant, but it really is from God. We know that's not how it works. And Mary faced everyone, because she promised to walk a path that the Lord placed before her. It was a path that was called the birth of a Savior. She rode on a donkey from Nazareth to Jerusalem, 9 months pregnant. I have spoken to many women who have ridden in a car coming to the hospital when they start to go in labor. They don't like that. Now imagine being on a donkey for days, 9 months pregnant, with your bladder about this big around. Yes, she did. Because she trusted. She trusted in a promise that was given to her by God. And God says, when you do this, when you walk this path, through you, I am going to bless the whole world. And so, as she travels to Bethlehem and she gets there, there's no place to stay. This is a pregnant mom getting ready to deliver, and the best thing that she can find is hay. Again, most of you would be overly excited. Away from family, away from anyone they know, and she's delivering a baby. She is just a woman. She was a woman of faith, but she was just a woman. She was asked to endure remarkable things for one very specific purpose, to bring to you and I this remarkable gift called our Lord. And so as the scripture says, the time came for her to deliver. It doesn't like it so easy. I've talked to many women who have delivered babies. It's not that easy. There was pain and burden and remarkable excitement and fear and misunderstanding and questions and all that goes through your head when you're trying to deliver a baby. But then there was this incredible joy. Because the Lord came into this world and it was her child. It was her little boy. And as she's holding this little boy, and as she's cleaning and taking care, and as she's calling him like we always do, and as the joy was in her face, then she has these guys invade her home. They're called shepherds. And they start saying, "Do you understand who this child is?" And she grasps some. Could you imagine God asking you to care for his son? Do you understand what an overwhelming reality? I had an overwhelming reality just when I took care of my own kids. And not one of them was perfect. I know that's hard for you to believe, but they weren't perfect. And yet, Mary was asked to care for God's son. On a path the Lord had asked her. So that he could walk to a cross, and so that she could have a sword running through her heart, as the scriptures teach us. Also that you and I would understand that this day we celebrate something remarkable. The birth of a Savior. Who became man so that he could suffer and die. Who became man so that he could walk perfectly and the law fulfill it and remove the burden from us. So that we would stand before the throne of God, holy and cleansed because of what Jesus so willingly did on our behalf. It is remarkable what God has done. I love what Mary was willing to do. It was by the gift of the Spirit. But she was one strong kid. Would have loved him better. Everything God did to prepare her heart, to prepare her soul, to grant her the strength, to walk with her, to guide her and direct her, was all for the benefit of us this day. So that we can sit here and know the wonder of the celebration of the birth of our Savior. And if it doesn't make you excited, there's something wrong with you. There is no greater news that we could ever have. You know, last Sunday morning, I had these four kids. Four kids right here. These four wondrous human beings right here. Same up there. And I love when they sing because for the first time in the service, I could just sit down and listen. And what they sang was simply a hymn. What was it, Frank? Yeah, it was "What Child Is This?" We know what child it is. And it is our Lord. So share it with each other. Get excited. This is good. I know Germans don't get too excited because we don't like that exciting stuff. But you should be. Doc has freed me to jump rope. Am I excited? You're darn right I am. There is just all kinds of things every day that we have all this joy in because of one fact, which is the basis for everything, that our Lord was born. Because the Lord had prepared, taken, formed, shaped, guided, directed, strengthened, encouraged, and enlightened Mary so that she could accomplish what nobody else would ever do. It came time for her to deliver. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. And his name was Jesus. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Gracious Lord, as we come before you this night, we thank you for the knowledge, the hope, and the life that you have given us in Christ, for the celebration we have in our hearts of the birth of your Son, and for the wondrous knowledge that we know that he is truly our Savior. There is only one hope in this world. It is a hope given to us through the death and resurrection of our Lord. And his birth announces that wondrous plan that you had in place to grant to us that forgiveness. And so we ask, dear Lord, that you would bless our families, bless our gatherings, strengthen us in your child. Help us to always rejoice in the wondrous love and faith we share. And may we always lift each other up with the comfort and forgiveness that you have given to each of us so freely. This night we ask a very special blessing upon Bree Duran. You know her child, taken from her before it was even born into this world. And so we ask, Lord, that the comfort that only you can provide would truly touch her this night and going forward. Because it is your Son that has given us life. And so we place Bree into your hands and ask your enrichment and blessing upon her. And as your people, dear Lord, we're privileged to look to you. And we do this night once again in the prayer that your Son has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, O hail. When Christ was born, O night divine, O night divine. Truly he taught us to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. With hymns of joy, in grateful chorus raising, let every heart adore his holy name. Christ is the Lord. With saint and seraph praising his power and glory evermore proclaim. O night divine, O night, O night divine.
Christ, on the same night which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, for this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And after the same manner also he took the cup, after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Drink of it, all of you. This is the New Testament in my blood, which has been shed for you for the remission of all of your sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. May the peace of our Lord be with you always. Amen. Would you please? As we always do on Christmas Eve, it is continuous flow, so that I can have one final blessing upon you all. So you will just be asked to come forward, receive the bread and wine, take the time you need, and then go back and be seated, and then I will give one final blessing at the end. Let us pray. Please take and eat of our Lord. Very gracious Lord, it is love for you to touch your heart and provide your blessings and his goodness. Please take. True body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, given to death, the forgiveness of all your sins. Very gracious Lord, the wondrous gift of his love, touch each of you and provide you with his blessings and his goodness. Please take. Body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, given to death for the forgiveness of all of your sins. And may our gracious Lord and God bless you. rise. Now may this holy body and this precious blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ may he both strengthen and preserve you and keep you in the one true faith until life everlasting. Depart this night in the peace that he has so freely given to you. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, you gave your Son into the world on the most holy night. Grant us the blessing of your Spirit, so daily we will share the blessing of the birth of our Lord with those you bring into our lives. Help us to live in honor of his name, and may we bring your goodness into the lives of many. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hero.
Blessings to you. Safely travel home.